नमस्ते गुरुजी।
नमस्ते। ओम श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ओम। सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। गुकारस्वन्धकारो वै रुकारस्तन्निवर्तकः अन्धकारनिरोधित्वात् गुरुरित्यभिधीयते। ॐ सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यङ्करवावहै, तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहैः। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ ब्रह्मविदा आप्नोति परम् तदेषाभ्युक्ता सत्यं ज्ञानमनन्तं ब्रह्म यो वेद निहितं गुहायां परमे व्योमन् सोऽष्णुते सर्वान् कामान् सह ब्रह्मणा विपश्चितेति। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। तत्र एतच्चिन्त्यं कोऽयमेवं वित् कथं वा संक्रामतीति, किं परस्मादात्मनः अन्यः संक्रमणकर्ता प्रविभक्तः उत सः एव इति। स य एवं वित् अस्माल्लोकात् प्रेत्य एतमन्नमयमात्मानमुपसंक्रामति। दिस् वास् द वेदिक् स्टेट्मेण्ट्। एवं वित् अस्माल्लोकात् प्रेत्य अन्नमयम् आत्मानम् उपसंक्रामति। द वन् हू नोस् ब्रह्मन् इन् दिस् मेनर् एण्ड् वाट् इस् दिस् मेनर् वाट् एवर् विच् हेस् बीन् सो फार् टोल्ड् अबौट् ब्रह्मन्। सो वी हेव् सीन् आल् द वे फ्रम् सृष्टिप्रक्रिया to panchakosha prakriya to ananda mimamsa and all that, where it was clearly shown that this brahman is the cause for the entire creation and is the indweller also. Like that it has already been shown how this brahman is, and evam vith, the one who knows like this, asmal lokat pretya, bhashyakara actually had used the term that this loka means all this worldly engagement, right? Having withdrawn oneself from all that, this person gains this annamayati atmaswarupa. This is how the explanation was given in the bhashya. Now the purvapakshi comes and asks this question: how come a brahman is trying to know itself? So either you have to say the jiva knows brahman, or you have to say brahman knows itself, and both are not acceptable is what is his question, is the statement. Okay, so now we were seeing this tatra eta chintyam. We have to look at it. What do we have to look? Kaha ayam evam vit, who is this person? So when you say that there is a jnanam which is taking place, evam vit means what? There is a jnanam taking place. Now, who is this person who is gaining this knowledge? That is the question. So, katam va sankramati, how can there be a sankramanam? Sankramaha means a learning or becoming one with, or whatever it is, obtaining. What is this kind of becoming, you know, one with the annamayadi atma? What does this mean is a question. Kim parasmad atmanah anyah. Parasmad atmanah means paratma, parabrahma vastu. Atmanah anyah sankramanakarta pravibhaktah uta sahayevai. Anyah parasmad atmanah anyah means what? The atma which is other than the paratma. The atma other than the paratma is jivatma. There are only two things, that two types of atma, right? Jivatma and paratma. The we call it as Paramatma also. It's the same thing. Paraatma is other than the Jivatma. These two things we always talk about. Now this Purva Pakshi is asking this question. Parasmad Atmanaha Anyaha means what? Is it the one which is other than the Paraatma, means Jivatma? Is it the Jivatma who is the Sankramana Karta? Is it the Jivatma which attains this Brahma Sakshatkara? Is it the Jivatma or Saha Evaiti? Is it the same Paratma itself which is gaining oneself? Kim Tataha? What is it? Tell me. If it is so, then what happens? This is a question. This is Siddhanti is asking this question. Kim Tataha? So by asking that question, what are you trying to arrive at? Is what he's asking. So then Purvapakshi is saying, Yedi Anyaha Syat. If the one who is knowing is other than the Paratma, that is, if the Jivatma is the one who is knowing that I am Brahman, then there is a Shruti Virodha. What is the Shruti Virodha? Shruti has said, Tat Srishtva Tadeva Anupravishati. Shruti is saying in the same Upanishad, having created, it alone entered itself into that creation. The one that created is the one which entered it also. That means the indwelling entity is also Paratma. See, this indwelling and all, we have already explained. There is no indwelling. But if you have to take it in a very superficial sense, Tat Srishtva Tadeva Anupravishati, whatever is the one which created is the one which has entered also. If this is the statement, then you can't say it is the Jivatma which is knowing, because whatever, what is the one that is created, it is only Paratma which does the creation. Jivatma has no capability to create this whole world. Correct? I don't even know what is happening in the next room at this time. If that is the case, where is the question of me creating this world? Therefore, you can't say Jivatma created the world and entered the world, right? That is not possible to say. So you have to accept that only Paratma has entered the world. If that is what is said, then how can you now say that Jivatma is the one which is knowing itself as Paramatma? Because Jivatma is not the one which actually created the world. Therefore, he says there is a Shruti Virodha. And two, three things he is quoting. One is this Tat Srishtva Tadeva Anupravishate. And then he quotes Brihadaranya, Anyaha Asau, Anyaha Ahamasmi, Iti Nasaveda. The one who, see, this question itself is answered in this sentence. If you look at it in the proper way, correct? So we know that because Paratma is self-evident, there is a possibility of error which can happen in any self-evident object. That is what we are talking about. It is the Ajnana Nivritti. But this person is not keen to understand and all that. So this Purva Pakshi is looking at it like a karmata or a laukika person, right? Therefore, he is asking this question. Anyaha asau, anyaha aham, iti nasa veda, the one who thinks. So this is a quote from Brihadaranyaka. Brihadaranyaka is saying that if somebody thinks that the creator, Parabrahmam, and the Jivatma, if those two are different, then if that is how one a person looks at it, then nasa veda, then that means that person doesn't have a knowledge of what is the reality. There is a statement. Therefore, what is the Purva Pakshi saying? He is saying that a Jivatma cannot be the one which is actually doing the Sankramana, because it can't be separate from Paratma. Therefore, you can't say Jivatma is knowing. Then the third one, Ekameva Advitiyam. There is only one thing. Therefore, you can't say Jivatma is the one which is knowing. Then finally, Tattvamasi. These four Vakyas disprove your statement if you were to say that it is the Jivatma which is attaining the Sankramana. Now, the other possibility it takes. Ata saha eva anandamayam atmanam upasankramati iti karma kartrutva अनुपपत्ति ही सपोज अथ सहायव सपोज यू से दैट दैट परात्मा ओनली बिकॉज दैट इज वाई सय एवं विद दिस सहा मीन्स ही टेक्स नाउ द सेकंड ऑप सो देयर आर ओनली टू ऑप्शंस ही टेक्स one is the jivatma is the one which is doing the sankramanam which he is dismissing because the shruti vakyas are there which shows that it is only the brahman paratma which is actually indwelling therefore you can't say jivatma attains it now the third option he is speaking is I mean the second option he is speaking is suppose you say that the paratma brahman only is knowing itself if you have so that's the only second option because either the jivatma has to know or the paratma itself has to know right now here he is saying ata sahayeva anandamayam atmanam upasankramati iti therefore if you say that the paratma is the one which is doing the upasankramanam then what happens karma kartrutva anupapattihi you can't say the same person is the karma as well as karta so I cannot say I beat myself. I mean, in the sense, I can beat this body. Hand can beat the leg. That is okay. But the karma and karta can't be the same. Therefore, the knower and the known. The known is the karma. The knower is the karta. So that kind of upapatti is not that is anupapannam. That kind of karma kartru karakam is untenable. Therefore, you can't say the Paratma knows itself because that kind of a statement doesn't make any sense, right? That is what he said. Parasya eva cha samsaritvam parabhavaha va. So he says the Paratma cannot have samsaritvam. Okay, or you can't say there is no Paratma at all. Okay, so those both are not tenable for you. यदि उभयता प्राप्तः दोषः न परिहर्तुं शक्यते इति व्यर्था चिंता सो द पूर्वपक्षी इज सेइंग सो इफ द बोथ द पॉसिबिलिटीज हैव द दोष दैट इज इफ द जीवात्मा इफ इट इज जीवात्मा विच इज हैविंग संक्रमणम दैट पॉसिबिलिटी दैट इज नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज वी हैव श्रुति इज सेइंग दैट परात्मा इज द वन विच इज इनसाइड So you can't say Jivatma suddenly has become Paramatma or something. So that is not tenable. The second possibility is Paratma knows itself. Again, it's not possible because the karma and karta in a sentence can't be the same. I can beat a elephant, but then elephant beats itself doesn't make sense. So there should be a different karma and karta. So because of this there are two both have doshas if both the doshas are not possible to be eliminated or parihartum na shakyate means you don't have a solution for these issues with the two propositions right you the both the stands if you don't have an answer to these conflicts or contradictions then what is the point in we doing an analysis because these are the only two possibilities you don't have an answer for both then why are you unnecessarily wasting time vyartha chinta so what is the point so he is actually inciting bhashikara so actually bhagavad pada looks like got upset if you see the later part we will see today he literally you know gets into a fight with this purvapakshi he even asks why do you say that I won't answer this kind of thing okay we'll see ata anya tarasmin pakshe dosha praptihi तृतीयो वा पक्षः अदुष्टः सः एव शास्त्रार्थः इति व्यर्था एव चिन्ता सपोज यू आर सेइंग बोथ आर नॉट अत अन्यतरस्मिन् पक्षे दोष अप्राप्तिः तृतीयो वा पक्षः अदुष्टः सः एव शास्त्रार्थः इति व्यर्था एव चिन्ता सो इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू डू दिस दोष आर इफ यू से दिस काइंड ऑफ अ दोष you know is fine ata anyatarasmin pakshe if you take any one of the stands dosha praptihi then what happens tritiyo va pakshaha adushta if you suppose have there is a third possibility even that is not there here what can be the third possibility it can only be a bheda bheda vada means there is an abheda and there is a bheda so you have to bring both like a hand can beat the leg like that you can say there are two parts Jiva and Paramatma are parts of the same Brahman, and then this can see that, something like that you have to bring. Okay, if you have to bring those kind of arguments, then also, right, why are you unnecessarily making these kind of statements? Because everything seems to be an untenable proposition. He says, na tan nirdharanarthatvat. Bhashikara says, okay, you are raising all this question, that is fine. But the whole discussion is because we need to find an answer. I agree that these kind of questions can be raised. Tan nirdharanarthatvat eva chinta. So in order for us to determine what is this sankramanam which is going on, is why all this analysis? Now you are just raising Purva Paksha and then saying Varta Chinta, Vyarta Chinta, what is this? Yes. Okay. And then he adds to it. He says, Satyam Praptaha Doshaha Nasakyam Parihartakyaha Parihartum Anyatarasminne Tritiyeva Pakshe Adushte Avadrite Vyarta Chinta Syat Natu Saha Avadritaha Iti Tad Avadaranarthatvat Arthavatiyeva Yesha Chinta. He says, if these cannot be resolved, satyam praptaha doshaha nasakyaha parihartu. Suppose if it is not possible to resolve the defects in either of these arguments, anyatarasmin, or tritiyeva pakshe adushte avadhrite, okay, suppose there is no third possibility, which is also not avadushta, na dushta. Okay, dushta means what? Untenable. Okay, then what happens? Then chinta is vyartha only, correct? So if both these don't hold, and if there is no third possibility also, another possibility, then the chinta is vyartha. But here, saha avadhritaha iti tad avadaranarthatvat arthavati eva yesha chinta. Okay, so for now, we are only analyzing, right? So is it possible or not feasible, an answer? So that is why the chinta is. Okay, therefore, arthavati chinta, shastrarthatvat arthavati eva yesha chinta, shastrartha avadaranarthatvat. Okay. So he says, why are we doing this analysis? Because shastrarthatvat, shastrartha, shastra, artha, avadharanarthatvat. So we need to, hey, shastram is telling you something. So we need to understand what it is trying to say, correct? We can't dismiss all possibilities and say there is no point in thinking about it. Because shastra has a purpose. It is not, we have certain shraddha towards shastra. We are here trying to look at what it is trying to say. Correct? Therefore, Arthavattu Eva Shastram. Therefore, we have to see what it is trying to say. Avadharanarthatvat. Then he says, this Pura Pakshi says, Chintayasi Chattvam Natu Nirneshyasi. He is now provoking. He is saying, you do analysis and all that, but you are not arriving at any conclusion. Nat Nirneshyasi. Okay? You are not concluding, you are not deciding what is correct. You just keep, churning wheels. That is how the Purva Pakshi is saying. Then Bhashyakara says, Kimna nirnetavyam iti vedavachanam. Why are you saying that? Okay. Is it like set in stone that, I won't be making any decision here what is the basis for you to make that statement? Then Purva Pakshi says, na. Bhashyakara says, katam tarhi. Then why are you talking like this? Why are you saying that I won't come to a conclusion about this? What makes you think like that? So it looks like there is some debate. Somebody is coming and talking like this to you. Then that Purva Pakshi is saying, bahu pratipakshatvat. He says, hey, he tells Bhashyakara, whatever you are saying, there are so many opposing views. Bahu pratipakshatvat. So the people holding opposite views are many, manifold. And he explains, the Purva Pakshi explains, he says, Ekatvavadi tvam, Vedartha paratvat, Okay, you are a ekatvavadi. You are saying everything here is one. There is only one. We call it Brahman, Ishvara, whatever, but all that is here is one. That is your stand. That is the ekatvavadi. Vedartha paratvat. Okay. However, you are Vedartha para means you are taking Vedartha, Veda as the param, and you take that is the Vedartha, that everything is one. Whereas Bhagavohi Nanatvavadinaha. Vedabhahya, so there are two types of people who are opposed to you. One is nanatvavadinaha, people who believe in Veda, but they say everything is separate from each other, different from each other. Nanatvavadinaha, there are many gods, and then you are different from God. Each God is different from the other. You are different from every other individual. You are different from the Jagat. Like the Dvaitavada. That is Nanatvavada. There are many. There are like millions of lives. Jivarashis. And there are so many planets. There are multiple things. So that is a Nanatvavada. And they may still believe in Veda. Right? So the Vaidikas who are Nanatvavada. So there are many people like that who are opposed to you. And then Vedabhahyaha Tvat Pratipakshaha. There are also people who are outside of Veda who are against you, like the Bauddha and all these people. So, if you look at you versus others, almost everybody is against you only. Therefore, Ataha Mama Ashanka Na Nirneshyasi Iti. So, therefore, I doubt, I suspect that you won't even answer this. You are just doing some vyartha chinta. Oh, is it saying this? Is that saying that? You don't determine. So I have a feeling that you can't answer everyone. There are so many different views. So most people are like saying things other than you. So they should have some truth in what they are saying. So this is what he is, this fellow, this Purva Bhakti is saying this. So there should be some, that's what he means, right? He's saying, he's basically trying to say, hey, there are so many other views. You hold one view. Okay, there are 1,000 people. 999 people are holding another view. You are one guy here. There is no way you can answer each one of those views. So you are just churning wheels, spinning wheels, just by saying that, hey, we have to do this chinta. But I think you will not even answer. Okay, is what he says. Then Shankara answers. He says, Etadeva. Me swasti ayanam, swasti ayanam, yanmam eka yoginam, aneka yohi bahu pratipakshamatha, ataha jeshyami sarvan, arabhe cha nintam, actually it is chinta. He says, I see it only as an advantage. Okay. He says, yetadeva, I think, see the setup, here, I think I'm just guessing, right? The way things are going on. See, I'll tell you first what he is saying and then say what is the thing. So he is saying, Etadeva me swastiyayanam. So this is something which is good for me only. It is going to be my advantage. Why? Yanmam eka yoginam. Because I am the only one who is taking the stand that everything is one. Ekatva. Aneka yogi bahu pratipakshamatha. And there are so many people who are opposed to it. Some are Vaidikas, some are Avaidikas. Okay. Ataha Jeshyami Sarvan Arabheta Chittam. Therefore, I will win everyone. So, this is seems to be there is some kind of Vidvat Sadas going on, right? So, Shankara is presenting the Advaita here. And then he has so many others who are there. Who are either Vaidikas who are trying to bring their points of view, or there are others who are Avaidikas who are also there. Okay, so what he is saying, Bhashyakara is saying is, it is good that all of them are assembled here, right? Now, even though one may say there are 999 other Vadas, see, technically anything which is not Advaitam is Dvaitam only. Okay, there are only variances about how each of the Dvaiti looks at it. Some may say Sankhyavadi might say that everything is Prakriti. There is one Prakriti and there are multiple Purushas. Like amoeba, right? So there are many Purushas which is sitting on Trigunatmika Prakriti. And the Prakriti, once that balance is reached, then people will be happy. So like that is their construct. Now there is a Nayayika. Then there is a Mimamsavadi. Mimamsaka will come and say that, hey, there are many Jivas. There is no Ishvara. There is only Karma Pala. And then you do this Karma, you will get some Pala and you will go to Swarga and all that. So there is a difference, right? There is a difference in the way each of these Vaidika Darshanas talk about. And then there is a Bauddha who comes and says everything is Vishya. There is no Ishvara, right? So all these are there. Now, in one way or the other, there is one thing common across all of them, which is Dvaitam, right? They are not saying, some are saying there is Ishvara, some are saying there is no Ishvara. But whoever is saying there is Ishvara also are saying that Ishvara is different, Jivas are different, correct? Therefore, the Dvaitam is a common thread. So when Bhashyakara is taking the fight to them, all he has to negate is there is no Dvaitam, there is no second thing. The moment he does that, then all of them are defeated. So you don't need to specifically say Sankhyam is wrong, correct? So the moment I say everything here is Brahman, it is implicit that all this Prakriti Purusha Veda is gone. It is also implicit, like in the Nayayika's case, that there are Anus and all those things, right? They have their own definition of different worldly things. Again, each of those definitions doesn't need to be individually contested. The moment you say there is no second thing, all the other Vadas are gone. So also, one thing we have to remember here, this majorityism, right? This means majorityism, right? The Purva Pakshi is saying, majority says there is no Advaitam, right? In that crowd. So how come you will be able to establish, right? This majority minority doesn't work. This is like saying there is an elephant and then there are the story, right? Where there are so many blind men, each looking at an elephant from that person's perspective, right? One is saying elephant is like a pillar because he's touching the leg. Another person is saying elephant is like a wall because he's touching stomach part of the elephant. And another is holding the tail and then he is saying, you know, it is like a banyan tree. And somebody is holding the trunk of the elephant and he is saying elephant is like a snake. And another person is touching the ears and then he says elephant is like a fan. Now, the majority have a view, right? One person doesn't accept all that. Because he sees the elephant completely. Now all these majority people, some five people are saying it's like a pillar. Another six people are saying it is like a banyan tree. Another 10 people are saying it is like a fan. Now another guy comes and says, all of them are right in their own way. Let us do an integral yoga. Okay, bring them all together. Right? So it has attribute of a pillar, this, that. So, and then that is another definition. That's a new definition. So, there are four pillars on the top of which there is a wall standing by the side of a banyan tree. Like that, this person gives another interpretation of what is an elephant. So, this is majorityism, right? They all come together. That doesn't mean just because they are in majority, the truth of elephant is different, correct? Because jnanam vastu tantram. The truth of an object, the reality of the object doesn't change. The knowledge has to be true to what the object is. So that is very important. That's why Bhashyakara says, in one stroke, I can negate all of them. Therefore, etadeva me swasti ayanam. So ayanam swasti, my way is clear, right? So my route is very clear because all of you are all here. You guys have all come together, right? Collected in one place. I don't have to separately go and win over each one of you. So it is good So I don't tell me that I'm not going to come to a conclusion about this. So I am happy to address all of you. Therefore, arabhecha chintam. So let us start the analysis. Why I say that this is what it is. Sayevatu syat tadbhavasya vivakshitatvat tadvijnanena paramatmabhavaha ki atra vivakshitaha brahmavidapnoti paramiti. Then he brings the Siddhanta Paksha. Okay, Bhashyakara says, Saha evatu syat. So you are saying there are only two options. One is Jiva is the one which is attaining the Sankramanam. Second option is Saha, the Paratma only, is attaining the Sankramanam. So the second option is what is the answer. Because he is asking, no, Nirneshyasi, why don't you select one out of the three? Either say it is Jivatma, or say it is Paratma, or there is a third option. You tell one of the three is what the Purva Bhakti asked, right? So Bhashyakara is answering him. He says, Saha evatu syat. So now I am choosing and I am answering you. It is the second one, which is the Paratma only is doing the Sankramanam. How are you saying that? Tadbhavasya vivakshitatva. The context is that. Again, it is all about context, right? Tadvijnanena paramatma bhavaha hi atra vivakshitaha. The context is paratma bhava, because from what? By the knowledge of it. Tadvijnanena, the jnanam of paratma is the one which is going to give you this sankramanam. See, all this sankramanam and all is only about knowledge, correct? We understand that. Because it is not, there is no annamaya atma which a Brahman has to go and reach, correct? It is about at knowledge level, there is a recognition what it is. Therefore, this Sankramanam is about that, about knowing. Therefore, Brahmavita apnoti param is the context. Brahmavita param apnoti, the one who gains the Brahman gains everything. One who knows the Brahman gains everything is the context. Therefore, because that being the Vivaksha, the Brahman only is the one which is knowing this. Now, obviously, it's not going to satisfy the Purvakshi, because Purvakshi already has addressed their question, right? Which is not yet answered. Therefore, Purvakshi comes and asks that question. Nahi anyasya anyabhava apattihi upapadyate nanu tasyapi tadbhava apattihi anupapanna eva. The first na is Bhashyakara saying, he further explains, Nahi anyasya anyabhava apattihi upapadyate. So he is dismissing the first possibility, which is Jiva knowing Brahman, right? Because this is a very standard question. Even today, even Visishtadvaitis and others ask this question. They think they ask a great question. He says, who gains the knowledge? Is it the Jiva who gains the knowledge, or Brahman gains the knowledge? If Jiva has to gain the knowledge, if it is anyway separate from Brahman, then how can you say tat srishtva tadeva anupraveshade and all that? Therefore, Jiva is not the one who could be knowing itself. Then if it is Brahman, then Brahman can't know itself, because it can't become karta and karma. This is a standard question, right? Therefore, first thing Bhashyakara is doing is that Jiva attaining Brahman is dismissing. Okay. Nahi anyasya anyabhava apattihi upapadyate. One thing can never become another. A pot cannot become a book, right? Because a clay can become a pot, but clay remains the clay but becomes pot. But a clay pot cannot become a book, correct? So, anyasya anyabhava apattihi na upapadyate. Therefore, a jiva cannot become a paratma. If you take a jiva means what? A upadhi included only, correct? Therefore, with all the attributes, a jiva cannot become Brahman. Anyasya anyabhava apattihi na upapadyate. So one cannot become another. Therefore, you can't say jiva can become Brahman. Therefore, I am dismissing the first possibility. I am doing the nirdharanam that it is only the Brahman which does the sankramana. Then the Purva Bhakti is asking, Nanu tasyapi tadbhava apattihi anupapanna eva. So even I have already asked you a question, that how can Brahman become the karta and karma of the same one? See, one sentence should have A beats B. You can't say A beats A, right? Karta and karma can't be the same. This is contention. And Bhashyakara says, Na avidya krita తాదాత్మ్య అపోహార్తత్వాత్. ఓకే, సో ఇట్స్ స్టాండర్డ్ ఆన్సర్, వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్ ఇట్ మెనీ టైమ్స్, బట్ ఇన్ ద కాంటెక్స్ట్ అగైన్ ఈ ఆన్సర్స్ దిస్ పర్టికులర్ పూర్వపక్షి. ఈ సేస్ అవిద్యాకృత తాదాత్మ్యం, సో ఇట్ ఈస్ అవిద్యాకృత తాదాత్మ్యం. తాదాత్మ్యం మీన్స్ వాట్? ఐ టేక్ ఇట్ యాజ్ అనదర్ థింగ్, తాదాత్మ్యం. ఓకే, దిస్ ఇస్ అధ్యాస, శోభనాధ్యాస అండ్ ఆల్ దట్. లైక్ యు ఆర్ సూపర్ ఇంపోజింగ్ ఎ స్నేక్ ఆన్ ద రోప్, లైక్ దట్ హియర్ ఆల్సో అవిద్యాకృతం. సి భాష్యకర్ ఐ యూసెస్ దిస్ అవిద్య. దర్ ఇస్ ఐ థింక్ ఐ టోల్డ్ ఇన్ వన్ ఆఫ్ ద క్లాసెస్ దట్ దర్ ఇస్ అ హోలే నర్సింగ్పూర్ సంప్రదాయ, రైట్? దే సే దర్ ఇస్ నో అవిద్య అట్ ఆల్, అండ్ దెన్ దే సే శంకర నెవర్ టాక్స్ అబౌట్ అవిద్య, దర్ ఇస్ ఓన్లీ అధ్యాస. ఓకే, సో అట్ సమ్ ప్లేసెస్ భాష్యకర స్పెసిఫిక్లీ యూసెస్ దిస్, ఈ సేస్ అవిద్యాకృత తాదాత్మ్య. సో తాదాత్మ్యం ఇస్ అధ్యాస, కరెక్ట్? అధ్యాస మీన్స్ వాట్? సూపర్ ఇంపోజిషన్, సూపర్ ఇంపోజిషన్ ఆఫ్ సంథింగ్ విచ్ ఇస్ నాట్ స్వాభావిక ఇన్ ఇట్, కరెక్ట్? లైక్ అతస్మిన్ తద్బుద్ధి, రైట్? అతస్మిన్ తద్బుద్ధి మీన్స్ వేర్ ఏ క్వాలిటీ ఇస్ నాట్ దేర్, యూ సూపర్ ఇంపోజ్ అ క్వాలిటీ ఆన్ ఇట్. ఓకే, దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ అధ్యాస. సో హియర్ ఆల్సో తాదాత్మ్యం మీన్స్ ద సేమ్ థింగ్, అండ్ తాదాత్మ్యం ఇస్ డ్యూ టు వాట్? అవిద్యాకృతం. Only when you have ignorance, you will superimpose something else on it, right? Only if I don't know that what lies in the half-dark area is a rope, then I can superimpose a snake or a stick or whatever in it, right? But if the moment I know it is rope, I won't have a superimposition. So therefore, avidya is the cause for tadatmyam. Therefore, they say, right, avidya has two qualities. One is avaranam, another is vikshepam. So it covers and it also creates an impression of something else. So both attributes are there for avidya. So here avidya krita tadatmya apohartatva. So what for is this jnanam? The jnanam removes not just ajnanam, avidya, but also tadatmya apohartatva. So all the effects also it removes. The cause is avidya, the effects are many things, right? So because I don't know Brahman, the effect is not one thing. There are multiple things which are born out of it, right? I take as myself as this body, then I take the world as separate from me. I add so much value to so many things in the world, right? And every samsara problem that I have is because of what? Tadatmya poha, tadatmya mandi, avidya krita tadatmyam. And apohartha means to destroy. Destroy what? That avidya as well as its effects. For that only this jnanam is there. So he says, yahi brahma vidyaya swatma praptihi upadishyate sa avidya kritasya annadi visheshatmanaha atmatvena adhyaropitasya manatmanaha apohartha. So he further explains the same statement, he gives little more color to it. Like in Bhashya, right? He first makes a simple statement, avidya krita tadatmya apohartatva, is a simple statement. Now he basically further dwells on it. Like the South Indian meals, which is how he used to say, in South Indian meals, in that big leaf, they'll put little bit of everything. Before they put rice, you will have little bit of two varieties of sabji, then dal, sweet, everything you'll put. And then you taste each one of them. And then you can take whatever you want, you add more. Okay, put me some more dal, you put some more sabji, whatever, right? But initially they give a little bit of everything. So like that, Bhashyam also typically does it that way. First he makes a very cryptic statement and then he elaborates. He says, yahi, even this question answer format is also to do that. He could have directly said that this ajnanam will be removed by jnanam, right? Instead, there is a big purvapaksha argument and then he is unfolding. Because in our mind also, the different possibilities are brought up. Because see, today if I make a Siddhanta statement, you might listen and go away. But once you are back, there may be so many questions which will come up, right? Therefore, Pachikara brings up
multiple angles to it, what are all the possibilities? So Jiva has the jnanam, or Brahman itself has the jnanam. If Brahman, then how does the jnanam take place? All those he himself analyzes. So he says, Yahi Brahma Vidyaya Swatma Praptihi Upadishyate. So that Swatma, this Atma Prapti, is being spoken about because of which Brahma Vidya, because of that Brahma Vidya, Sa Avidya Kratasya Annadi Visheshatmanaha Atmatvena Adhyaropitasya Anatmanaha Apohatma. Okay, so this Annamayam, so this Annamayam Atmanam Upasankramati, Pranamayam Atmanam Upasankramati, Manomayam Atmanam Upasankramati, Vijnanamayam Atmanam Upasankramati, Anandamayam Atmanam Upasankramati. So he gains all of these. Why are we talking about these five koshas? Because those are the areas where we commit mistakes, right? I take myself to be this physical body. So I commit an error at the level of physical body. Then I commit an error at the level of prana, then manaha. Like that, each of these are areas where I commit an error and say, I could be prana, I could be manaha. Then what the Shastra says, this body itself is not an individual entity, right? This physical body is part of the entire Annamaya Samashti. So the total Annamaya is what this Annamaya Sharira is part of. And this Brahmavitta gains this entire Annatma Prapancha, right? The Samashti Annamaya. Similarly, it gains Pranamaya, then Manomaya, the Sutratma, then we saw all that, right? Hiranyagarbha and then Ishvara. So that's how it goes. So all these are gained and each one of them is negated. So once I say I am the Samashti Prana, I have already negated that I am this Annamaya Sharira. So all the way it goes, and finally this Anandamaya also, its Kucham is Brahman. Therefore it negates all these things. Therefore Avidya Kritasya Annadi Visheshatmanaha Atmatvena Adhyaropitasya Anatmanaha Apohartha. Apohartha means that destroys, removes, but this Avidya Krita, not just Avidya, but all the products, effects of it. Annadi Visheshatmanaha Atmatvena Adhyaropitasya. So one has superimposed oneself on oneself, all this physical body, prana, manas and all that. So even at Samashti level. Okay, first is eliminate. So this is Adhyaropa Apavadabhyam Nishprapancham Prapanchate is a statement. So in fact, Bhagavan in Bhagavad Gita uses it all over. Okay, so we call it as a method of knowing Brahman. So first you do Adhyaropa and then an Apavada. You eliminate it. What is Adhyaropa? You superimpose more qualities on it. See, this one Annamaya Sharira I have. But you bring the point of view that the entire Samashti Annamayam you are part of. Which is a fact also, correct? This Annamaya Sharira is part of the Samashti Annam. So because this is born only of food. And this is sustained by food. And this goes back to food. And it is part of that entire food chain, correct? So that means this Vyashti body is part of Samashti. Therefore, I can own up the Samashti Annamayam. So there is an Adhyaropa of the Samashti Annamaya Sharira. Similarly, Adhyaropa of Samashti. So I am, my prana is part of the Sutratma. Because my breathing is connected to Samashti, right? There is no individual breath. So my prana, I am breathing in an air which is circulating everywhere. Now, that means there is a connectivity, there is a continuum of the breath. So there is a Samashti prana. So then that is also Adhyaropita. So earlier I was thinking I have only this much of breathing. But now Shastra is showing me that, hey, your breath is not an isolation, right? It is part of one continuum of air, the circulation system. Similarly, mind also is part of Hiranyagarbha because there is one Samashti conscious order which is working. So it's not that you are just here without, you know, the sunlight.
without a system which is bringing you water, which is bringing you food, a system which is actually making life sustain, and all this is being done in unconscious way. Therefore, there is a samashti conscious awareness, like your mind is, right? Your mind is part of that continuum. So again, there is adhyaropa of a samashti mind. So likewise, all the five levels of adhyaropa is done. Then an apavada is done. Hey, are you really the physical body? Not just this body, even samashti level. So then once you have done apavada, you have kind of done apavada of almost everything that you can conceive of. Then what remains is not this physical samashti or prana samashti or manomaya samashti or vijnanamaya samashti or even the experiential anandamaya samashti, but only the swarupa. So that alone remains as you. Therefore, adhyaropa apavada abhyam nishprapancham. Nishprapancham means this brahma vastu. There is no prapancha, right? So it, you gain that nishprapancha only by adhyaropa and apavada. Okay, in Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavan keeps doing this. Okay, atmatvena adhyaropitasya anatmanah apoharta apoharta. This jnanam removes all the ajnanam and its effects. Katam evam arthavata avagamyate vidya matra upadeshati. Katam evam arthavata. How can you say only by knowing this you can gain? Won't you have to do some other stuff? Vashikara says vidya matra upadeshati. Katam evam arthaha arthavata avagamyate. Okay, see, the question is different. The question is asking, hey, you are saying by knowledge all this ignorance and its byproducts are removed. What is the basis of this conclusion? Katam evam arthavata avagamyate. How are you arriving at this conclusion? What is your basis? Then Bhashyakara answers, vidya matra upadesha. He says, here only knowledge is spoken about. It is not asking you to do any action. The Shastra is not telling you to perform anything. Vidya matra upadesha. It is only giving you a knowledge. So when it is giving you only a knowledge, that means its intention is only what? To remove ignorance. Because always knowledge removes ignorance. It doesn't do anything else. So, if its job is only to remove ignorance, then you can obviously conclude that removal of ignorance is going to give you paraprapti. Correct? So, vidya matra upadesha. Because vidya alone is emphasized here, I am concluding, Bhashyakara is saying, I am concluding that this all this annamaya upasankramanam, all that is by removal of ignorance, one that from Brahman itself gains. So it is as though gaining. Okay. So we have seen that many times. It is Vityagarya Mandi. So the question comes because somebody is asking to that person, we have to answer this jagat, this, all that stuff, right? So because the Ajnani is there, therefore we are answering. But if you look at it from the Paramartha Drishti, there is no such thing. It is all only as though. So that's why Bhashyakara is saying vidya matra upadesha. Only by ignorance removal alone is the intent here. So because the Shastram is not asking you to do anything. So he is explaining further. Vidya yasya drishtam karyam avidya nivrittihi. So the knowledge does only one action. It is one effect is avidya nivrittihi. Removal of ignorance is the only effect of a knowledge. Satyaiha vidya matram atma prapto sadhanam upadishyate. Therefore, for atma prapti, there is only one means, which is vidya eva. Knowledge alone makes you gain your atma. Marga vijnana upadeshavati. Then he asked another question, is the saying marga vijnana upadeshavati? No, you can't say that. Suppose Karmakanda, you can say, okay, this you can ask them to do an action and all that. See, here it is marga vijnana upadesha, is just giving you a route. Okay, I have to go from Chennai to Bangalore, so I am just giving you a direction. You just go towards western direction and take whatever highway there, and then take a right turn at some place. It just gives you a direction. So it is like that. So why can't you take it like that? It is telling you, for this Brahma Prapti, this is the way to do. So why can't you take it like that? And then the person has to walk. So why can't we take it like that is the Purvapakshi's question. Tadatvatve vidya matra sadhanatva upadeshaha ahetuhu. कस्मात् देशांतर प्राप्तो मार्ग विज्ञान उपदेश दर्शनात् नहि ग्राम एव गन्ता इति चेत्. ओके, ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट. पूर्वपक्षी इज एक्सप्लेनिंग देशांतर प्राप्तो मार्ग विज्ञान उपदेश दर्शनात् टू गो टू अनदर प्लेस. Somebody can give direction. He doesn't have to tell you to, this is the route. It's what is a statement. Okay, so vidya matra sadhanatva upadeshaha hetuhu. So only even for giving a going to a place, all you need is knowledge, right? Vidya matra sadhanatva upadeshaha hetu. How he is explaining, saying deshantara prapto marga vijnana upadesha darshanat, and he says nahi gramaha eva ganta. So you can't say the village only is going, right? Just because a description is being said, that how do you go to a particular village, you can't say village itself goes to village. So here also is the drishtanta that Purvapakshi is giving is, hey, I am telling you how is the paratma to be reached, right? That is what shastra is telling. That doesn't mean the paratma itself reaches itself. You can't tell like that. Like in the case of example, so there is a direction being told how to go to a grama, doesn't mean grama itself is going. Okay, then he says na vaidharmyat. Hey, Vashikara says the example you are giving is totally different. These are two different things. There is a vaidharmyam. Why is it different? He says tatrahi grama vishayam jnanam na upadishyate tat prapti marga vishayam eva upadishyate vijnanam na tataiha brahma vijnana vyatirekena sadhanantara vishayam vijnanam upadishyate. In your example, what is being told? You are not describing that village. Okay, in your example, the village description is not given. Only the route description is given, correct? So if I have to go to Mathur village, so what will I be told? Hey, you take a train, you go to this station, get down in Mangalore, whatever, and then you take a bus. So it is all about route. Not, hey, Mathur has these attributes, Mathur has, you know, 54 houses. I don't say that. That is what Vashikara thinks. Whereas in this case, there is no talk about how to gain or anything. It only talks about Brahman, right? Therefore, Vashikara is giving this tatrahi grama vishayam jnanam na upadishyate tat prapti marga vishayam eva upadishyate vijnanam. Only the route to the gramam village is actually told. Na tataiha, unlike that, in this case, Brahma Vijnana Vitirekena, other than what is Brahman, Sadhanantara Vishayam Vijnanam na upadishyate, no other means to gain Brahman is spoken about here. Ukta karma adi sadhana apeksham Brahma Vijnanam paraprapto sadhanam upadishyate iti chet. Then he is not leaving this. Purvapakshi is saying, Ukta karma adi sadhana apeksham. Hey, already that karma, all of them have been spoken about in Karma Kanda. Ukta karma adi sadhana apeksham. So there are so many karmas which have been spoken about. Whatever nitya karma, naimittika karma, so many things have been spoken about. Then Brahma vijnanam paraprapto sadhanam upadishyate. Okay, so those are already spoken. Therefore, here only Brahma Vijnana Vishayam, which is an effect of whatever this Karma Kanda Sadhanam has been told. How is this Brahman?
that you are going to achieve by following the karma which has been told in the earlier part of Veda. Maybe it is like that, is what Guru Bhakti is saying. Then he says, na nityatvat mokshasya ityadina pratyuktatvat. First, that is not acceptable. Why? Because moksha is already said to be nitya. Correct? Nitya means eternally there. You can't say karma kanda told you some karma. After doing that karma, you are going to now go and gain, get a new moksha. Because moksha is already nitya. It is not sadhya vastu. Brahman is siddha vastu. Siddha vastu means it is already gained. Only by your ignorance you are aware. We already discussed the example. I was reading using glasses. Then, you know, my wife brought me a cup of coffee. So I kept the newspaper down. I moved my glasses to my head. Now I drink the coffee. And then some other worker comes. I speak to that person. Then some phone call comes. So I take the phone call. After some time, I start searching for my glasses. That glass, is it a siddha vastu or sadhya vastu? Okay. In a way, it is sadhya vastu because I have to still gain it. For now, I don't have. When I want to read the newspaper, my glasses are not available to me because I don't know where I kept it. I keep searching for it all over the house. I don't find it at all. So now I have to read the newspaper, but I don't have the glasses. So the glasses are sadhyam. The glass is a sadhya vastu. I still have to get it. Correct? At the same time, it is already a siddha vastu because I already have it. Just that it is not in my eyes, but it is in my head. On the top of my head. Now it is a siddha vastu, but because of ignorance, it is also a sadhya vastu because I haven't gained it. So we can't say it is a sadhya vastu. It is siddha vastu because of ignorance only. It is not siddham. Therefore, when the ignorance is removed, then the glasses are available to me. That I can just bring it down. That's all. Right? Similarly, here nityatvat mokshasya. Shastra is already saying the moksha is nityam. So you are already mukta, but because of your ignorance, it is away. Shutischa tatrishtva tadeva anupravishati iti karyastasya tadatmatvam darshayati. Therefore, Bhashyakara is saying, it is the paratma which is gaining itself. Okay. So it is not jivatma and all that. Jivatma, we just use that phrase. There are no two things. There is no separate jivatma. There is no paratma and all that. There is only one Brahman. So because of ignorance, all this is there. Because it is self-evident atma, right? Because it is self-evident, it lends itself to error. So you make an error, multiple errors, because of avidya, then all the karyas are there. And once this avidya goes away, then you just recognize that all that is here is Brahman. In fact, the cognition is, there was never a jiva. Okay, that's why when the vritti happens, the sakandakara vritti happens, it's not that yesterday I was a jiva and then this akandakara vritti happened and today onwards I am Brahman. It's not like that. Okay. That vritti just removes the ignorance and then you just recognize that there was never a jiva. Where is jiva? In fact, only when there is srishti, when there is jagat, all that, then you talk about jiva and stuff like that. So when the clay, the moment it knows that it is clay, from clay standpoint, there was never a part. Pot is as though a pot, that's all, right? You say it holds water, whatever, right? There is a pot. But from a clay standpoint, it never let go of its nature to be a clay. there is no part. From a clay standpoint, there is no part at all. See, I was a clay, I am a clay, and I will remain a clay. Right? So that's how this jnanam is. So there is no jivatvam. So jiva becoming, you know, Brahman, all that. So Bhashyakara very clearly says that, hey, there is no jiva. So who gains this sankramanam? It is the sarvatma only. The paratma only is. Then the question is answered. What is the question? The question is how can the karta and karma be the same? The karta and karma can't be same only if there is a true action. Right here, it is not that it is going and knowing itself. So the ignorance is knocked off. That's all. And then it is self-evident. The Atma Swarupa is self-evident. It is not that it had an ignorance before and it got removed or anything. But because somebody is asking this question, then we have to answer within that. So that's why this Ajnana Nivritti also is within the Mithya Bhutam. So it is not, there is no true ignorance which is removed. Okay. So that is how the Satyam Mithya works. So that's why Bhashyakara answers it, you know, in those lines. Interesting Bhashyam. Om. पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्तिः 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 हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ
धन्यवादः गुरुजी धन्यवादः गुरुजी